At a time when technology has oppressed the masses, we must celebrate things made by human hands. Welcome to the Craftys Awards for 2015. Celebrating the best in crafts and DIY.
Including fashion sewing, edible crafts, decorative painting, and much more. Judged by Beth Kingston, Kingston Crafts, Lisette Kennedy, Nick Jr., Aaron Flaherty, Marie Claire, Lisa Gastineau, Gastineau Jewelry, Tamara Kelly, Moodly,
and your host, Mark Montano. Welcome to the Craftys Awards 2015.
Presented by Zyron.
And here's your host, Mark Montano.
Welcome to the 2015 Craftys Awards, the award show that celebrates the best in crafts and DIY. We've poured over thousands of entries submitted to the Craftys, and tonight we'll reveal the winners. What's at stake in this year's head-to-head crafts throwdown? Winners of each category receive $200 in cash and $1,000 for best in show. Plus, the glory and power that come with wielding a trophy from the Craftys. It might look just like a bowling pin, but with just a smidge of paint, it's so much more, don't you think? What a crafty year 2015 has been, right? I mean, Miley Cyrus has taken glitter to places never thought physically possible. And now, pics from your Instagram feed can be transformed into a coaster or on cupcakes, even a tramp stamp. I've seen it and I've tasted it. The cupcakes, just the cupcakes. Now you may be wondering, what does it take to win Best in Show? Technical expertise, an innovative approach, and a great artistic sensibility are all important. Plus a certain distinctive, oh my God, factor. Stephanie Close not only made her own wedding dress, but created a gown from a material much craftier than expected.
I think there were a lot of people who said, I had no idea a knitting wedding dress could look so nice. I think a lot of people were expecting me to show up wearing a gigantic sweater. I've been knitting since I was a little kid. I did it off and on when I was little, and then I picked it up again when I was in college because I was a philosophy major. And I was stuck in all of these sort of lofty things all the time, and putting in some time and actually having something to show for it was so incredibly refreshing that it really just changed everything for me. My father, I think, has always been a little surprised that I choose to make so many things myself, because he came from a family where you made things out of necessity, and it was a mark of success when you didn't have to do that anymore. Where I think now, it's a mark of success that you have the ability and the knowledge and the desire to make things yourself. I feel crafting connects me to all of these generations of women who've come before me. Winning was incredibly gratifying, and being recognized for all of my hard work, it was really wonderful.
Before Stephanie won the Best in Show Award, she first won the Best in Knitting category. Watch for some of amazing pieces knitted in this year's full-length dress in Watch for some amazing pieces knitted by this year's contestants, including a full-length dress inspired by Frozen's Elsa that a teacher created to wear at the prom.
Thank you.
The winner of the knitting category receives $200 and a gift card for a bunch of Red Heart yarn. And the winner is Children's Carousel by Sachio Isi. Said one of our judges, Sachio's attention to detail is impressive. The use of short rows for the carousel base, frayed yarn for the horse manes, and twisted fringe for the tails is really smart, and I think so too. Crochet had over 100 entries this year, making it one of the most popular categories of the Craftys. The finalists included a policeman's uniform, a VW bus, and even an apple pie. The winner of the crochet category also receives a wonderful stash of Red Heart yarn. And the winner is Storm Dancer. Storm Dancer is a yarn bomb that interprets social anxiety with wings, and our judges described it as fantastical and fun and expressing an important message. So next year, social anxiety crafts will be one of our biggest categories. In the world of wool, there's one craft that's a little underappreciated, felt crafts. Often misunderstood as child's play, it's actually the medium of great artists. Take a look at one of our finalists.
I'm Megan Barber. I'm originally from southeastern Ohio. Right now I'm living in Brooklyn, New York, and in the evenings and weekends I like to spend a lot of my time making abstract felt pieces. So people tend to be confused about what textile art is, especially if I'm using felt, something that they traditionally, you know, put with more like children's crafts. So I usually show them a picture right away, like, no, it's this thing that I'm making. Like, oh, I finally get what you're trying to describe. But then it kind of goes back to, wait, you have to cut out all of these circles and this takes hours and how did you, what is this even going to be at the end? I got more funny reactions with the plush creatures. They would describe it like the sprites from Rainbow Bright on acid. So I use a lot of color combinations that I would see in nature or something that I would think would appear in a more, you know, fantastical fantasy type universe. I like lichen on rocks. That was a big inspiration. You can see in a lot of the thread pieces that come out to the felt circles. Those were all supposed to look like kind of another organism climbing on top and how they all intertwined. And also, if you notice, none of the lines are perfectly straight. I try to do just curved lines as the felt fabric feels like it should be curving that way. More technical pieces on plushies, or especially with knitting, that's much more technical. I had to really go in with a very strict plan, and I was trying to control the projects a bit too much. This taught me to, once you let things go a little bit, you might discover something new.
This year's Felt Crafts category finalists include a whale, a Wookiee, and a seagull that you can wear on your head. What more can you ask for, felt fans? The winner of the felt crafts category is Mabel the Whale. As one judge said, I love Mabel's shape and most of all her expression. I didn't want a whale before, but now I want a whale. I kind of want a whale too. Felt crafts is a new category for the Craftys this year, as is decorative painting. Now, what category would you add to the Craftys? Tweet it at the Craftys and we may add it next year. But on to the decorative painting category, where one of the finalists waved a magic wand and turned a root cellar into a gnome forest. The winner of the decorative painting mixed media category is Shop Things, a mixed media painting made with hose clamps, C-clamps, brad nails, star washers, and grinder washers. Wow. If this one doesn't get us a Home Depot sponsorship, I don't know what will. Now on to the general crafts category, which is anything but general. It's a potpourri, a cornucopia, a melange, if you will, of the crafts that we couldn't find out where to put anywhere else. And it also has some of the most amazing work, including a doll's dragon costume, a gourd carved into a chickadee nest, and a goth bag covered in blood. How scary is that? And the winner of the general crafts category is Vein of Leaves by Dan Zhang. The leaves are made by recreating leaves using a hot glue gun. Now, Dan is my new personal hero. Bless you, Dan, and all you can do with a hot glue gun. Now, at this point, you may be wondering how the crafty choices are made. Is it an esteemed panel of wizened craft masters and a band of magical fairy gnomes that live in a root cellar? Basically, yes. We have judges from some of the most noted publications and manufacturers in the craft industry, like Better Homes and Gardens Crafts, Blog Her, Epicurious, and Chronicle Books, plus experts such as Vicky Howell, Ed Roth, and Carol Heppner, helping to choose the winners based on technical merit as well as an innovative approach and artistic ideas. Technique and artistry are both important in the quilting category, which includes finalists inspired by pirates, raccoons, and scraps. Let's take a look at what an amazing amount of scraps can inspire you to do. the winner of the quilting award category is Flea Market Flower Pot Quilt. One judge said, the crosshatch quilting pairs nicely with the ribbon candy design in the sashing strips. That's a tip for all you aspiring quilters out there, although I have no idea what that means. Keep your sashing strips tight. All of our nominees put in dedication and hard work into their creations, but few put in as much time as the designer profiled in our next piece. See if you can spot.
This dress took me probably a year to make in different steps. I was really inspired by the Andrew Zuckerman book. So I took some illustrations from the book and I went over them with tracing paper and tried to get as much detail out of it as I could. And then from that point, I kind of just organically went about putting the sequins and seed beads. I think after a while, I kind of get into like a flow state. So a lot of times I'll either watch Law & Order or I kind of gauge that, like, oh, it's only 5 Law & Order episodes and then I'm done. But it's funny to see people's faces when I'm like just starting to the end, because like from the beginning it's kind of like just this mess of beads and junk all over the table. And I'm like, no, it's gonna be an idea, like, I promise, it'll be something. This one time I think it was the bird even, I was embroidering it and like my dad saw just the wing. And he was like, what are you doing with that? I was like, oh, it's gonna be a bird. And he's like, all right. And then when it was all done, he was like, wow, it's a bird. And I was like, yeah, that's what I said. I think there's a lot of doubt along the way. Like you kind of like question yourself and what you're doing. But as long as you can just get past like each step and like, okay, I only have, I don't know, another hour and then this part will be done. And then I can kind of go from there. I think that really helps with me. I just keep lying to myself, like, oh, only one more hour, only one more hour. And then all these hours add up and it's done eventually.
See if you can spot which finalist was inspired by the Statue of Liberty, a father's army blanket, or a 2,000-year-old bog body. Now, in case you're wondering, a bog body is a naturally mummified corpse found in a peat bog, usually in Northern Europe. Who knew? Kyle DiArcangelo was inspired by the single seam coat to make his work Chrysalis. Let's see the fashion finalists. And the winner of the Craftys for fashion sewing is Allison Montemayor for her dress, the crane. Now, why create a dress that celebrates such a weird looking bird? She was inspired by the dramatic features on this odd little guy. And wow, is he odd. Paper can be turned into things you'd never expect, including a trailer park, a wedding cake, and even a bunny. But only one can be the winner of a Crafty Award. Thank you. The winner of the Paper and Scrapbooking Award is Flower Power. One of our judges said, the design takes the simple subject of a paper flower and uses a complex technique for a beautiful finished piece. I think so too. Now to award the sticker art category, I'd like to introduce a co-presenter, my friend Beth Kingston of Kingston Crafts, who's one of the stickiest people I know.
To award the best sticker category, I'd like, oh, that's me.
Yeah, that's you.
It's me.
Yeah, that's you.
Sticker artists work with paper in a very different way. They turn those sticky pieces of paper into mini canvases that convey an artistic message on anything they're stuck to, including street signs, my bitchin' longboard, or the back of Mark's Trapper Keeper. And the winner of the Craftys for sticker art is Frank Ape, an icon created by Brandon Signs that's been stuck, painted, and wheat pasted throughout New York City.
Many of the great projects entered into the Craftys are not only beautiful to look at, but are also inspired. Here are some of the interesting stories shared with the Craftys in 2015.
Hello, fellow Craftys. I want to share with you a barrel purse made from a Pringles can. These crocheted sun hats are made from Mylar from video cassette tapes and entitled Braveheart for the movie used to make them. The Lamp of Liberty. Mistresses love them, wives tolerate them. I use crochet to work with materials associated with jewelry and metalsmithing. I hope to blur the separation of what is considered fine art and craft, and at the same time, examine the value contemporary society places on traditional women's work. These dolls are crochet versions of my husband and I on our wedding day. My original bouquet was crocheted calla lilies and carnations, so I made a teeny version with embroidered floss and a bit of hot glue to keep it all together. This sofa was from the home of our town's first horse and buggy doctor. All of the fabric used to create the accent pillows also came from the house. In the 1920s, dinner parties and family gatherings were the main entertainment, and that also meant the tablecloth, runners, doilies, and Chanel bedspread were gorgeous. I was really struggling with my vision loss and the news that it was deteriorating faster than expected. I ended up drawing a picture of myself praying to keep the faith. Then, I translated my drawing into crochet. The stitch I used looked like angels. I'm most proud of this design, and I hope to inspire others. This bracelet was inspired by my deceased mother-in-law, Rose Philomena, also known as Rosie Posey. An industrious seamstress, she worked from home to raise her two boys. The button box she left behind was filled with good inspiration. The city of Detroit is the inspiration for this piece. The geometric shapes evoke the Art Deco architecture. Lit with miniature LED lights, the lampwork glass beads blink like the taillights of cars of Detroit.
When it comes to great stories in the crafting world, bloggers are often the ones to tell them. Our nominees for Best Craft Blogger includes one about luxury DIY, another about budget upcycling, and everything in between that can be glued or glittered.
Thank you.
the winner of the Best Craft Blogger Award is One Artsy Mama by Amy Lotta. One of the prizes for the Best Craft Blogger is the opportunity to pitch a book idea to the editors at Chronicle Books, which means she may be coming to these very offices very soon. Congratulations, Amy. If you've never seen a piece of jewelry that makes you look like an octopus, you're about to. Get ready for dazzling baubles that look like honey, horsehair, and the streets of Detroit. The Crafty Award for Jewelry also comes with an amazing prize package from Beadaholic. And the winner is Sweet Honey by Leslie Foster. It's a lampwork piece inspired by honeybees with drips made out of molten glass. Now, if the talk of honey is getting you hungry, it's time for the Edible Crafts Award. This year's delicious creations include a witch hat, sneakers, a tackle box, and a Dolce & Gabbana purse. Beautiful enough to wear, and also a great dessert. The winner of the Edible Crafts Award is the Air Jordan Shoe Cake by Lisa Rogers. Said one judge, the attention to detail on this shoe is nothing short of astonishing. The eyelets, the gray and black pattern, the UPC code, you got it, it's all there. I personally think this is the best way to put your foot in your mouth. Now we go from food to drinks. Our next profile is about a crafter who turned an old TV console into the perfect man cave bar.
Okay, my name is Bill Claypool. We're in Cedarville, Ohio, and I refurbish, repurpose, and refinish. We've got this group called the Repurposers, and there's six of us, and we look on Craigslist, we look at garage sales, estate sales, and we try to find stuff that's what I think is unique. There might just be something that grabs my eye, like that old TV set that I turned into the Coke bar. And everybody says, well, make an aquarium out of it. I'm like, well, everybody does that. And then people make dog beds out of them. I'm like, I just want something different. I had a countertop that I hand painted. It said Coca-Cola on it, and I hand painted it. And I took that countertop and I went and set it on top of that console TV, and then the wheel started turning. You'd be surprised at some of the stuff, the really cool stuff I found at the curb. And I'm not a trash picker by any means, but on Thursday mornings, I'm sometimes late to work because I'll say, yeah, that's a pretty cool whatever it is, and I'll stop and pick it up and take it back home. And whenever you do something that It's never been done before, like this bench I'm sitting on. There's no blueprints. I had a guy tell me a long time ago, because I was painting something on a wall, and he said, you're kind of artistic, aren't you? I said, yeah, a little bit. He goes, you know what that already looks like, and you haven't started yet. I said, yeah, I kind of do. I can see it in my head, and I know what it's going to look like. It's really, you know, it really makes me feel good that I can sit there and think of something like that. The artist in me comes out, and I want to try stuff like that.
This year's home decor finalists include a floor made out of yardsticks, a mirror made out of flowers, and post office boxes turned into a desk. In addition to $200 in cash, the winner of the Home Decor Craftys Award also receives a bonus package from Deco Art Paints, my favorite paints. And the winner is Times Square Dresser. Now, we realize that there are people who show their love of crafts through pinning and posting, which is why we have a category for the best DIY Instagram or Pinterest account. With this category, the judges are looking for creative curation, a keen eye, and clinical digital hoarding tendencies. A great example of this is Marilyn Hughes's Pinterest board, all about paper gift tags. Note to Chronicle book editors, this is a coffee table book waiting to happen. The winner of the best DIY Instagram account is Angela Martinez's God is Love project, which chronicles her adventures anonymously gifting crocheted hearts with positive messages by leaving them behind for anyone to take. Now, what makes a great online handmade store? Is it a clever concept, beautiful pictures, great products? I say all three. The finalists in this category sell beautiful felt tableware, refashioned vintage suitcases, and much more. Thank you. The winner of Best Online Store is Super Buzzy, which only sells Japanese textiles. Said one of our judges, Super Buzzy is one of those stores you can just get lost in for hours. The future of creativity is with young crafters, which is why it's exciting to award creators under the age of 18. This year's finalists include an ode to the demonic mannequin Chucky, a full-length crocheted dress, and an owl-shaped backpack. Winner of the Best Young Crafter Award is the Corkboard Map by Colby C., who is the creator of the site Love Joy Glitter. Now I'd like to welcome back Beth Kingston to award the Best in Show.
I'm so excited. The time has come for the big award of the Craftys, Best in Show, which comes with a $1,000 prize. Hopefully you've been keeping notes and placing bets on your favorites. Did you love the Times Square dresser? The honeybee necklace? Storm Dancer? Let's get another look at the category winners. And the winner of the Best in Show Award is...
Before we thank everyone for tuning in, we want to give a special shout out to Katie Smith of Punk Projects, who entered almost every single category in the Craftys with awesome pieces.
Yes.
And to see more of my videos, check out my YouTube account, Make Your Mark.
I do love your videos.
And we'll see you next year at the Craftys.
Bye-bye. Wait. We got to do the Best in Show.
All right.
The winner of the Best in Show is... Dan Zhang, whose ability to create leaves with a glue gun just astounds us all. Thank you so much to our title sponsor, Xyron, and to everyone for watching. Have a great night, everybody.
Bye, guys. Thanks for watching. Bye.